daybreak, Sunday morning. Here, athletes assemble to test their will, pushing mind and body to their limits. Here, champions are born. Last year, this champion was born. 18-year-old Ben Canute stormed past his coach and mentor, Adam Zuko, and into the spotlight, a shining new star in the world of triathlon. This year, the coach and the kid are back, facing new challenges. On the women's side, ageless Chris Wickard, a two-time defending champion, takes on a slew of powerful young guns. Can she turn back the hands of time to dominate yet again? The answer, next. Scion, in cooperation with the City of Hammond and the Hammond Port Authority, present Leon's World's Fastest Triathlon.
This is Wolf Lake Park in northwest Indiana, just a few miles south of Chicago, where 600 amateur triathletes feel the need, yes, the need for speed, and the best of them are going to be flat out flying today. It's Leon's World's Fastest Triathlon. Hello, everyone. I'm Tim Morris alongside Robbie Ventura, former professional cyclist and Ironman, of course. And Robbie, last year we had a terrific race out here, but this year it's shaping up to be even better.
Absolutely. I mean, last year we had five or six people in contention. This year we may have 25 people in for the win. And it's kind of a neat story that's playing out. We have the older guard, right? We have Adam Zuko, Jen Harrison, Chris Wickard, the experience. And then we have the young guard, the new triathletes coming into the game, Adrian Shields, Ben Canute. And it's going to be a battle between youthful exuberance and, of course, experience.
All right, let's take a look at the contenders. And, of course, we have to start with our defending champion, Ben Canute.
One of the most talented youngsters. He's 19 years old, Geneva, Illinois. He's going to make our Olympic team, I think, in 2016. I mean, he can run. The guy can swim, obviously. And now he's been working on his cycling. And believe it or not, he thinks he can win this thing again.
I'd say my chances are pretty good. I mean, the field is way deeper than it was last year from, I mean, the returning top three, Adam Zuko and Scott. So it's gonna be a little bit tougher, but I still think that I can pull off the win.
Last year, this guy, Adam Zuko, ran second to him. Of course, his coach and mentor, and it's shaping up could be the same thing this year.
He battled great on the bike last year, just got past in the run. We know he's a great coach. He's also a great competitor. This guy's got a few more tricks left in the bag.
I've been warning Ben, hey man, the Cane Club might be coming for you, so you might want to really kind of watch your back this year.
Absolutely. Another super talented athlete that Adam actually works with is Reeven Nathan. I mean, this guy won his last triathlon in 2011, turns professional, then goes to Israel and starts training with the military.
Yeah, fascinating story, and we'll learn much more about that later on. But let's turn to the female side and our two-time defending champion, Chris Wickard.
Chris Wickard is so good. She's going for a three-peat, and anybody can do it. It's Chris Wickard. She can raise her game on race day. No weaknesses. She's fast. She can run. She can swim. She can absolutely do it all. Dealing with a little bit of a bulging disc in her neck, but that's okay. My nod goes to Wickard today.
One of the people she's going to have to be looking at is her coach, Jennifer Harrison.
Absolutely. I know Jen Harrison for a long time. She's such a great competitor. She loves the sport. She loves helping other athletes as well. And for one thing, she loves competing here on local soil.
It's a great environment. It's great that we can just hop through the city, and it's really one of the first exits off the, you know, off 90, and it's a great environment. Lots of young people here, lots of new talent in this area. It's exciting.
Speaking of exciting, 18-year-old Jen Howland, four-time junior national champ. It's going to be interesting to see what she does.
She is so talented. I am excited to see what she can do. Now, it's her first Olympic distance triathlon. We'll see if she can put horsepower out the entire event.
And how about Adrian Shields? She's going to be a contender.
We call her the machine. She trains hard, she races hard, and believe me, she's got a plan.
Running is definitely my strength. I'm probably going to have some making up to do after coming out of the water. My goal is to not lose them too much in the water. I've been working a lot on my swim, so just hope to keep them in sight and come out of the water just gung-ho and try to catch as many people as I can on the bike, and then just chase them down on the run and just hope for the best there.
Of course, one of the really cool things about this race, Robbie, the team concept that Leon came up with, teams of 10, men, women, and co-ed, and it really has added to the excitement here.
Absolutely. If you look over my shoulder here, you can see these little pockets of teams. I think there's like at least 10 or 15 teams competing in this team competition, and it literally has brought the competition of this entire race up an incredible level. The camaraderie amongst the athletes, it really has, I think it's the first of its kind to actually have a team competition, and I'm excited to see how it plays out.
The camaraderie that comes from team can only be expressed if you're in a locker room. You get a bond. There's something special when you operate as a team. And to have that element brought into the sport of triathlon, it has totally caught the attention of everyone in the sport, and we are proud to be a pioneer in this aspect of the sport and look forward to continuing the team racing concept, just creating an experience that has never been seen before in the sport.
It's the Zoot Team Cup Challenge, and Robbie, I know you and your Vision Quest team want to take home one of these trophies.
Leon is absolutely right. This lifted the energy at Vision Quest. We tried to find the fastest men and women we had because we want one of those cups.
And as we go forward here, approaching race time, Leon, with his dedication and respect for the military and our troops, getting ready for the national anthem. Approach race time. Let's take a look at the course and conditions brought to you by Pods Moving and Storage. 0.9 mile swim starts the Olympic distance race, 66 degree moderate temperature water. Then 24.8 miles on the bike, where they might reach 36 miles per hour, the fastest guys. And 6.2 miles in the run. This is perfect conditions today, Robbie, for a low time.
Absolutely. Not a lot of wind. Temperatures moderate. Last year they went 202 and 216 respectively. I think with these great conditions, times are going to fall. Wow, those Scions are super cool. Now we have some track facts presented by, of course, Scion. We're going to bore down here on Wolf Lake Park. It's about 30 minutes from Chicago. We're going to take a look at the swim here, and you can see that island. That's the first thing these athletes will see when they start their swim. They're going to keep it off to their right-hand side. The neat thing about this swim course is really to have these buoys marking how far you're going. So for the swimmers that are a little bit nervous in the water, they can use those buoys for some comfort. They make a couple of left-hand turns, and of course, they head for home. They hit that very interesting sandbar with some of them will be dolphin diving, some of them not, and then, of course, the swim out to the bike transition.
Athletes jumping in the water, getting ready for race time. And Robbie, what's going through their mind right now?
These guys are trying to stay loose. They're trying to stay calm and control the things they can control.
I know you caught up with Chris Wickard.
Chris, you're just moments away from attempting your three-peat here just before the swim start. Talk about some of the stuff that's going through your mind this close to the start of the race.
I try not to think about it. You're going to make me nervous. I'm just going to go out. I want to have fun. I mean, I'm going to push it as hard as I can and see what happens. I mean, there's a lot of really fast people out here today, and, you know, I want to have fun. If I don't have fun anymore, I don't want to do the sport. So
there's a lot of intensity out here. How do you calm your nerves a little bit? You look very, very happy, very relaxed. What's your secret?
I keep it deep down inside. Don't show emotion. I've been doing it a long time, so it's like, you just end up, you get a little bit more used to it, but you're always nervous, so.
Congratulations and good luck today.
Thank you.
Chris Wickard in the water, the defending champion, expecting a lot from herself today as the 40 athletes of the All-Star Amateur Wave gather up for the start.
They're all sitting there treading water, fighting for position, waiting for that oh-so-important gun.
And there it goes. They're off. And everybody in very tight quarters at this point.
Yeah, they're fighting for position at this point. It's like a washing machine out there. They're getting kicked, they're getting punched, but they are fighting for that perfect line, and they're keeping their sights on that first buoy.
Contenders trying to find some clean water.
Absolutely. I mean, when you're out there, guy, and you're swimming as hard as you possibly can, you see Ben Knut on there taking the right-hand side. He doesn't want anybody drafting off of him. He wants clear water because this kid can swim.
He can swim. He's flying. We talked to him about his expectations in the swim.
I expect to come out of the water, I mean, top one or two. I mean, Dave Fix is a good swimmer, but, and there's always a couple of people who will hop on your feet or who you don't know about who can swim fast. But I mean, I expect to be coming out in the top five for sure, unless something weird happens. And then it's just kind of like go from there, just go all out and make everybody, whoever wants to work for it.
And he is working for it. Look at the lead he's built. Ben Knut, 10 to 12 body lengths. He's cruising.
Absolutely. Look at the weight coming off of his feet. I mean, I thought this guy was going to have a great swim, but to be this far ahead, this early in the swim, is absolutely unheard of.
Ben Knut under control. When we come back, the leaders head for dry land. 18-year-old Jen Howland firmly in command. And what's this? A senior citizen triathlete. What a story. Stay with us.
Leon's Triathlon is brought to you by Scion. What moves you? Luke. Zoot. VersaClimber, the number one total body cross trainer. Pods Moving and Storage. Body Glove. And Reactor, the best built performance sports watch, period.
To the men and women of the military, as a thank you for preserving our freedom of expression, Scion's giving you a $1,000 rebate. Express yourself any way you want with a Scion. And with Scion Pure Price, there's no haggle and no hassle. That's the code we live by.
What is Pods? A smarter way to move and store. We deliver a container, you or your packers fill it up with all the things that need a home while you move yours. Take all the time you need, then call us. We'll pick up your container and drive it to your new home across town or across the country, even to one of our many secure storage centers. That's Pods, the best moving and storage idea ever. Call today or visit pods.com for your free quote.
Don't miss Gary's South Shore Air Show featuring the U.S. Air Force Thunderbirds July 6th through the 8th. Watch in amazement as military and civilian aircraft fly over Marquette Park in Gary. This annual show offers free admission, food vendors, and a beer garden. Free parking and shuttle available at the Majestic Star Casino and Hotel. Premium parking offered steps from the beach. A twilight show with fireworks provided by Crazy Kaplan's will be held on Friday, July 6th. Visit www.garyairshow.com for details.
Margaret Mattson, Fine Jewelry, 312 South 3rd Street, Geneva.
Sunrise this morning. Check this out. This beautiful little Scion IQ being dragged out onto the lake on a barge. She floats! That is one well-engineered buoy. A beautiful day today. Not so beautiful, however, in the days leading up to this race. Cold and rainy. Guys from the Indiana, Kentucky, Ohio Carpenters Union getting it done in spite of the weather. All the heavy equipment rolling in. Leon right there to greet them. The aquatics unit setting up the buoys. And the city of Hammond prepping the road course. So much goes into making this race a success. And, of course, the Budweiser truck rolling in. That gets a cheer from the Carpenters. Budweiser sharing Leon's passion for supporting our military veterans, in particular through the Budweiser Fallen Heroes program and Helmets to Hard Hats, a program that helps returning veterans get back to work.
These people have done so much to sacrifice for our country, and we just want everyone to know how special this has become, the military component, and I just can't even begin in words to express all the energy and all the support we're receiving for that.
Back out to the water, and the men's swim leader, Ben Canute, opening up even a bigger lead now as he makes the turn.
Making the turn for home here, and we can't even see second place in the shot. This kid is having one heck of a day here in the water.
From the air, we can see the distance there. Probably that's Ryan Fredrickson in second place, probably a minute lead on him.
And then, of course, we have that third pack, and who is in there? None other than
Jen Howland, 18 years old, and she's hanging with some really good swimmers.
That's hyper impressive. She's actually in the group there with Adam Zuko, her coach. How much confidence is that going to give her, getting out of the water so far in front of the other women?
And back at the swim start, the amateurs getting ready to go in. And this is really what the race is all about, isn't it?
Yeah, over 550 of these people getting out there doing their absolute best.
Now, in Leon's amateur spotlight, we shine the light on 70-year-old triathlete Carolyn Vanderveld. Yes, I said 70 years old.
I'm 70. I'm an old broad. I was a gym teacher and looking for something to do other than teaching fitness classes and things. And I think when I was 58 years old, I decided I could run a marathon. And so I did. And after 30 marathons, they were boring. So I started to do triathlons.
Shoes and socks really quick.
Because of my age, I'm slow, but I'm careful and I pace and I get through it. It's a challenge that I feel that keeps me young. And one of the things that I see when I teach fitness classes in the water is people who say, you're my hero, you're my role model, I want to be like you. Well, you can, because I'm an average person. I feel like I should be saying to everyone else, if I can do it, you can do it. You say, I want to do this, do it.
She looks at everything and just says, I'm going to do it. She doesn't look at the obstacles in the way.
10 years from now, we'll be 80. I've always said I wanted to do a marathon at age 80. I will probably still be doing triathlons, but they might only be the sprint ones. I don't know, age 80, we'll see. It is so cool. It is so cool.
70 years old and still going strong. As we head back out to the men's leader, Ben Canute, and look at that lead.
He's got a great lead. He's got a great stroke going, a nice wake behind him, and he's actually heading for that sandbar we talked about earlier today. And there's a couple of ways to avoid that. You can stay to the complete left side of it, or you can dolphin dive through it. You can see the people standing up right there next to the Scion.
It's very shallow at certain spots there. Sometimes people dolphin dive. Sometimes people run. And now Jen Howland still back in the lead with the lead group of men.
Absolutely. It's impressive. There she is. She's actually battling the men. Look at her fighting for that position around that buoy. I love this girl. She's strong and she's tough. She's drafting on her coach, Adam Zuko.
Ben Canute now approaching the swim out.
He's coming out to the swim out. And the key here, guys, is to really keep yourself swimming as far as you possibly can. You don't want to start standing up too quickly. There's rocks down there. Like a professional, he's swimming all the way to the end.
Now getting ready for a long run across Wolf Lake Park from our Hasse Construction High Shot. Hasse providing all of the lifts this week for Leon's. You can see him starting to take off his wetsuit right now.
This is an unusually long run from the swim transition. I mean, he's got a minute to 2 minute run here. He's taking off all the clothes he can to make his transition as efficient as possible.
And look at that Scion FRS in the winner's circle. That's a beauty. As he makes his way towards transition, are his legs burning right now? How's his body feeling?
His arms and his upper body are a little bit pumped up. His legs, this is actually good for him because he's getting his legs warmed up. He's looking for his bicycle. If he was smart, and I'm sure he was, he put his bicycle in a spot where it's easy to get to. He left himself plenty of transition room because this transition time is really important. Here comes Fredrickson. I think he's in second place here. He's coming to the swim out, not nearly as smooth or as fast as our boy Ben Canute here.
And you can see the distance, obviously, in time between them. Fredrickson with a good swim, but not as good as Canute.
I had no idea we would see this sort of gap this early in the race for Ben Canute. It's going to be tough for anybody to catch him. He's got a minute and a half lead.
How's this transition look?
He looks very, very good. He's got an aero package, not like last year where he had a pretty basic setup. This year, he is ready to rock and roll. I wouldn't be surprised if he rips this bike up.
Ben Canute feeling it as we see this third group here of men coming in, and that's Fredrickson as he heads towards his bike.
Absolutely, with the Mohawk and all, he's ready for this race. He's fired up. He's representing that team well fit. And there, of course, we have Ben Canute getting back onto his bicycle. His shoes are actually attached to the pedals. He had a nice start there, and it's got to be frustrating for this pack of men to see a guy already on the bike.
And the silver cap, you could see Jen Howland getting out with those guys as Canute extends his lead on the bike, really pounding the pedals early on.
And there's Jen Howland coming out of the water. You can see here, she is an unbelievable position here, starting this race off with such a huge lead. Let's hope she can hang on.
That's the question. Someone like her and her inexperience at 18 years old, is she extending too much? Is she using too much energy?
That's the person to ask. Adam Zuko, he's her coach. And he looks confused. Oh my gosh. I think he actually lost his bicycle here for a second. Now he's found it. That's going to cost him some seconds in transition.
Seems like he's got it together here now, but like you said, the transition's so important because these are seconds you can't gain back.
And there's Jen Howland getting herself. She's the first female into transition. She's got to be psyched about that. Let's hope she keeps calm. She's got another long race to go here.
There's Reuven Nathan also putting his helmet on. Reuven.
He hasn't lost too much by going to Israel, that's for sure. I mean, he's out of the water in the lead pack. That's pretty good. You see Adam getting a little altercation there with one of the judges. These guys are a little bit confused and getting themselves out. Every second count here. I can't talk about how important this transition is.
So there are your men's leaders, Canute, Fredrickson, and Zuko in third.
Canute had an incredible swim, but we know Adam Zuko can bring it home on the bicycle.
Back to the women, and there's our defending champion, Chris Wickard, looking decent out of transition. She's in fourth place at this point.
She looks great, but she's got a lot of room to make up on Jen Holland, and I believe that's her coach there in third place, Jen Harrison, and of course, the machine, Adrian Shields, with a long way to go.
All right, let's reset with your women's leaders. Out of the water and transition, Jen Holland, Darcy Tofolo, Amanda Wendorf, then Wickard and Harrison. Coming up, more on this team phenom. We rode along with Jen on one of her workouts, and it was tough to keep up. And Robbie talks bike tech. When it comes to speed on a bike, equipment can make all the difference.
If this town's got it, so do we. On Demand has local content you can't get anywhere else.
Whoa.
Furry pets you can select. Single people who want to connect.
Yeah.
Local streets you can protect.
We're stopping crime together.
It's all on demand and at your command. Just click the On Demand button with your remote and explore exclusive local programming made just for you. Xfinity has the world's greatest collection of On Demand choices, now including local On Demand.
Get fresh as it gets at Strack and Van Til.
Made fresh in our kitchen.
Baked fresh every day.
Sliced fresh in our deli.
Delivered fresh from the farm.
Cut fresh by our butchers.
Always the highest quality. Always an unbeatable selection.
Freshness down every aisle.
Get fresh at Strack and Van Til. Visit one of over 16 locations.
Does the Suzuki Kizashi come with a special parking space maker? No. But it does come with available all-wheel drive plus 50 other awesome features. The Suzuki Kizashi, truly amazing.
0% for 72 months on all Suzukis at Richardson Suzuki in Highland, Indiana.
Welcome back to Leon's Triathlon. Yesterday was demo day. All the athletes checking in and checking out top-of-the-line gear from the best manufacturers this sport has to offer. Companies like Zoot and Zip, all the brands here top-notch. Team and training also on hand, excited as usual to be helping athletes and raising money for the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society. And how about Scion stepping up, outfitting Leon's with a bunch of their cool new cars? That XB really is sharp. All the cars drawing lots of attention. As was the Versa Climber. People can't seem to resist jumping on this cross-training machine. Extremely popular with triathletes. And Versa Climber, a great supporter of Leon's Triathlon.
Dan, my buddy from 83, has been with me with Versa Climber. And that type of relationship exemplifies what this whole event is all about. The loyalty, the commitment, the passion. It's from our heart and will always be from our heart.
Thank you, Leon. Now back out to the women's bike and Jen Howland, the 18-year-old.
You can see she has a pretty standard road bike, not as technically advanced as some of the other bikes we see, but she looks good on the bike. Her head is pretty low. She's pulling on as hard as she possibly can. The big question in my mind is, can she sustain a high enough level of speed to stay away from Chris Wickard?
And like we talked about, she may not even know whether she can sustain it. Now, to Ben Knute, we know he can sustain speed.
I mean, you saw how he just pulled out of that corner. He's got tons of legs right now. His head is nice and low. He looks very, very fast. And this kid loves one thing, and that's speed.
I love speed. It's just when you go fast, there's that, especially if you get the wind behind you, or you're going downhill or something, and you get in the right gear, it's just like a great feeling. It's like hitting the zone. It's when you get going that fast, it just like everything is clicking and let's go, let's keep this up. I mean, when you have a good feeling in a race, you want to keep that feeling for as long as you can, and you want to capitalize on it. So, I mean, it's really just about staying focused and just like trying to keep that feeling going.
Knute flying, and there you can see Adam Zuko, his coach, coming the other direction, trying to chase him down. Will he catch him again like last year?
I'm going to see if I can hold Adam off on the bike this year. I think I've improved a little bit with the added aero speed concept, and I think I can hold him off and at least make it closer than it was last year on the bike.
Adam Zuko got him in his sights, but he's got a lot of ground to make up.
Yeah, I think it was interesting, the point that Ben Knute made about technology. I mean, you can see Adam's bike. It's a very aerodynamic bike. He's got a disc wheel on the back. Ben now has that same technology, and it's going to be tough for Adam to catch him.
Jen Howland looking a little bit tired, but getting a lot of encouragement from teammates.
Come on, Jen. Come on, Jen. Come on.
We met Jen earlier this week and got to know her a little bit better. Rural Kane County, farm fields as far as the eye can see, miles of open roads. Most days, this is where you'll find Jen Howland, pounding the pedals or hammering the trails, mile after endless mile, chasing her dream.
It's something that I've chosen. It's something I've fallen in love with, and it's my passion in life. And if you have a passion for something, you just gotta keep going for it and keep following it. The adrenaline rush is something you cannot beat. It's just the rush of the crowd cheering for you and just having everybody support you, having my mom out there cheering for me as loud as she can, and my grandfather. It's something that can't be beat.
She's just 18 years old and a four-time junior national champion. That's not an accident. She has got some incredible talent, but it's her drive and her passion for the sport that fuels her fire.
You have someone who's so dedicated and so willing to do whatever it takes in order to get the job done that I almost have to watch the other side of the spectrum. Get that feeling and then back off. You know, I'm really big on having fun, and if you're having fun, you're gonna do well.
Jen graduated high school just yesterday, if you can believe that, so this a very big weekend. Sure, she's a world-class athlete, but she and her coach know it's important to set aside time to just be a kid.
Yeah, I do agree that you have to be a kid, but I just love training. It's my passion. I've been doing it for 9 years now. My summer is dedicated to triathlon and training.
Can't get enough, can you?
No, I can't. I love it. It's a passion. I'm in love with the sport.
What a talented young athlete and a star for the future, but not today, because in her rearview mirror, none other than Chris Wickard blowing past her. Can't she three-peat?
I'm gonna try. So, I mean, that's all I can do. I don't want to be going in and come off, you know, arrogant or anything. I don't feel like I am. I mean, everybody just goes in there, tries to give it their all, and if they come out on top, they come out on top. And, you know, definitely it's a goal. I mean, you know, nobody says, hey, I want to go in. I think I'll be third this year. So, I mean, that's just not, you know, people don't do that.
Chris looking great on that bike, and Robbie has more on how important technology is for speed.
It's no secret over the last 10 years, bike speeds have gone straight up in triathlon. A lot of that is training, a lot of that is athletes, but some of it is technology. And it's illustrated between these two bicycles here. This is a bike you may see at a triathlon about 10 years ago. It's made of steel, it's heavy, maybe 25 pounds. It has retrofitted aero bars. This one over here, a complete speed machine, made of carbon fiber, totally set up for the athlete to get in the most aerodynamic position they possibly can get in. The component packages, this is significantly lighter, it shifts much better. Also, the wheels are totally different. These are carbon fiber wheels. They're not only lighter than these wheels here, but they're also significantly more aerodynamic. Here's the deal, guys. Same exact athlete, same effort. This bike could get you home 5 minutes faster.
Jen Harrison flying on the bike, and how does her setup look?
It looks very, very good. I mean, you can tell she's a proven athlete. Her position is low. Her bike has all the technology necessary to make it go as fast as possible. You can see her flying through the bike course here, finishing the first of two loops.
Coming up, the battle between coach and student heats up. Jen Harrison pounding the pedals, trying to catch her star student. And speaking of speed, our own Robbie Ventura mounts up. Get ready for some tips on how to get it done on the bike.
The South Shore hosts extraordinary events all summer long. Watch in amazement as military and civilian aircraft fly over the beaches of Lake Michigan at Gary's South Shore Air Show. Enjoy free top name entertainment at Festival of the Lakes in Hammond. Or stop by the Pierogi Fest in Whiting, which has been featured on Oprah, the Travel Channel, and the Food Network. Festivals abound along the South Shore.
Race Leon's World's Fastest Triathlon is if you were there in person. Introducing Be There for your iPad. The world's first app that puts you in the action. Your fitness, your effort, drives the speed of the interactive app. Go to don'tjustworkout.com and make gym boredom a thing of the past. Don't just work out, be there.
What is Pods? A smarter way to store. We deliver a container, you fill it up. With things you're keeping for later and forever. Whenever you're ready, call us. We'll drive your container to one of our many secure storage centers. That's Pods.
It has 11 airbags, including the world's first rear window airbag, and the highest combined MPG of any non-hybrid. It's the Scion IQ, and it's ready to outsmart the city.
Welcome back. Leon's Triathlon has a rich history. It began way back in the 80s, Leon recognizing a need for an amateur national championship. The idea caught on quickly, and the race grew in stature over the years. After a brief hiatus, Leon brought it back 2 years ago, and it continues to grow and flourish as one of the most popular amateur events in the nation.
I'm here on my way back up the course for a second lap around Klein Avenue. And again, what do we have behind me? Ben Canoe. This guy is absolutely flying. Known for his swimming, of course we knew he'd lead out of the water, but we did not know he would put this sort of performance in.
Job, man.
Absolutely. This sport of performance in the bike leg. He continued to increase his lead. And guys, he has not changed at all in terms of his position or his power output. The regular person puts out about 150 watts. Ben's doing close to 400 watts. And he's been doing it all day long on his bike. And he hasn't sacrificed his form. 90 RPM, absolutely perfect. Head is low, super smooth. Ben is cruising this bike course. The story of the day, the improvement from Ben Canute out here on the bike course. Going a little bit hot for me. Guys, see you around.
Robbie, 12 years as a professional cyclist, having trouble keeping up with Ben Canute, as everybody does, but he's an outstanding cycling coach, as you'll see here in Robbie's VersaClimber Coach's Corner.
I can't stress enough the importance of the bike leg of the triathlon. It makes up over half of the athlete's total time. Be sure that these athletes will use a variety of techniques to make sure they're pacing themselves properly. One is heart rate. The other, power meters. Another one, speedometer, how fast they're going. And the third, intuition. Old school, baby. How do I feel? Am I going too hard? Am I not going hard enough? Pacing strategy will either make you or break you in today's triathlon. One element that can be a difference maker today is hydration and nutrition. These athletes have to make sure they're taking on enough fluid and enough calories to make it to the end of the race fully nourished. Some athletes will even take on maybe 200 to 300 calories to make sure they have enough energy to bring it home on the run. Going fast on the bike is not all about horsepower. A lot of it has to do with aerodynamics. Keeping your head low, keeping your arms low, getting that aggressive position to fight the aerodynamic drag can save you minutes across a triathlon. Let me tell you, getting aerodynamic is one thing, but being able to put out horsepower in that position is something else. It's a fine balance. Power, aerodynamics. It'll make a difference today, I promise you.
Adam Zucco, of course, a coach himself, knows how to get it done on the bike. You can see he's got his shoes off and ready for transition, but he's got to catch Ben Canute, who's way ahead of him.
Ben Canute's zipping out of transition here, looking absolutely fresh as a daisy. What's amazing here is the big reversal that happened from last year. Adam Zucco, his coach, destroyed him on the bicycle, chased him down. Now it looks like our boy Canute here is actually pulling away from Adam Zucco on the bike, and he's ripping out of transition.
A year more experienced and stronger, and you can see he's just got a bounce in his step. He looks strong.
Absolutely, looking fresh. He put the funny glasses on. He is really ripping out of transition, actually sprinting out of transition. I hope this doesn't catch up with him later in the run.
Still a long ways to go as Adam Zucco comes into transition, hopefully not confused about where his rack is.
He's been lost once. It looks like he's actually lost again. The second time he's been lost in transition here, he's going to rack that bike as quickly as he possibly can. Every second counts at this point. He lost more time to his boy Canute on the run, on the bike. He better pick it up here on the run.
And there is Reuven Nathan, of course, a fascinating story. We talked about him earlier. How's he look?
He looks very, very good. He's actually way far up on the leaderboard here heading into the bike transition. He's actually very, very quick, looking good. It's an amazing story, that's for sure.
Yeah, you talked to him before the race.
Well, I decided to go to Israel for just under a year. I joined the IDF, which is the Israel Defense Forces, the Israeli Army. I became the combat fitness trainer in one of the most elite infantry units. It's called Egoz. It's in Golani, which is one of the brigades, one of the five infantry brigades. I had an amazing time. I trained the best of the best. Combat fitness, 50 plus kilometer treks, hikes with 50% body weight, just awesome.
You become a pro triathlete. What possesses you to go do this stuff?
Well, you have to love the pain. I love the pain. It's hard to explain, but it's what drives me.
Tell us about some of the rigors and how that's going to transpose you into a better triathlete.
Well, my weakest part was always the run, so I think all these treks, all the miles on the legs, it's got to help with the running. My run right now is very strong. The swim and the bike suffered a little, but they should rebound back pretty soon.
Amazing story. This kid definitely with a bright future. All right, let's check into the top five after the second transition. Ben Canute, followed by Zuko, Jared Millam, Reven Nathan, and Ryan Fredrickson.
Coming up, the women heading for that all-important bike run transition. And crazy things can happen in transitions. Stay with us.
I love this city. Socks have always been a part of my life. It's baseball, but it's more than that. I can tell you where I was at almost any point in my life because of the Sox.
Fans. We're more than fans. We appreciate this game.
It's Pep Boys' National Tire Event. Buy any tire at our guaranteed lowest prices. Buy two tires, get an oil change free. Buy three, get the fourth tire free. Plus, store-wide savings on parts and accessories. Hurry to Pep Boys' National Tire Event, in-store and online 24/7 at pepboys.com. The guaranteed lowest prices on tires. We will not be undersold.
Pep Boys does everything for less.
This summer, he's back. Like he never went away. Roar Man in Black.
Big savings aren't alien to me.
Bob's Summer Blockbuster Sales Event. Lease a new 2013 Sonata for only $199 a month. Plus, get America's best warranty with a 10-year, 100,000-mile powertrain warranty, the Hyundai Assurance, and more.
Bob Roman Gurney Hyundai on Grand Avenue across from Gurney Mills.
Mark your calendar for next year's Leon's Triathlon. To register for next year's race, please visit us online at leonstriathlon.com.
This idyllic scene just down the road, the beautiful Indiana Dunes National Lakeshore. Over 4 million people visit the dunes every year. More than 15 miles of beautiful beaches, great hiking trails, a popular destination for families all across the Midwest. Really beautiful spot. Back out to our men's leader, Ben Canute, passing the Luke Water Station and looking strong.
Then we have Reven Nathan looking down at his watch, making sure that his heart rate as well as his pace per mile are in line. This is his first race back in almost a year.
Jared Millam, one of only two pros in the race.
You can see his high arms, his quick turnover. Jared is an excellent runner who is coming here to win, but he also has some other ideas.
I would say to have as much fun as possible. That's always my goal. So for me, having fun is going all out, giving everything I have and going for that win. But my personal goal, have fun.
And I'm sure he's having fun right now in third position, trying to run down Zuko and Canute.
You can see he's got those funny glasses on, but it's going to take one heck of an effort to make up the ground on young Ben Canute.
Adam Zuko in second place, passing the Luke Water Station, taking some water, important at this part of the race.
Absolutely, hydration is mission critical to keep these guys working strong.
Now back to the women, and Chris Wickard coming into transition with a nice lead.
Absolutely, she's got her bike in the right spot. It's at the absolutely end of the transition area. No worries about trying to find her bike. Quick helmet to take off, quick feet, already getting in her shoes relatively quickly. Good transition by Chris Wickard.
Not all transitions, however, Robbie, go quite this smoothly.
Jen Harrison having herself a much better transition with the shoes on. She's about 2 minutes behind Chris Wickard. Can she make it up? That's the question.
Chris Wickard is a very fast runner. Look for Jen Harrison to do everything she can, but it's going to be tough.
All right, so here's the women's top five. Wickard, Harrison, then Amanda Wendorf, Adrienne Shields, who's got a strong run ahead of her, I'm sure, and Aaron Kirsten. To the men's leader, Ben Canute, getting a helping hand from the community here in Hammond. Everybody's supportive of this terrific race. Thumbs up, thank you very much. And there's Adam Zuko trying to gain ground, but it's not easy with this kid ahead of him.
Again, looking at his watch going, how much faster can I possibly go? Let's break down this run course with another Scion Track Facts. We sped this up a ton. If only the runners could run this fast, this race would be over quickly. The beginning is a long, straight stretch. The athletes can see themselves very far away. Then we go by the Luke Water Station. Of course, they're going to take on valuable hydration there. And then we go through Pulaski Park Loop, where the athletes can get a little break from the sunlight shaded in those trees. And then, of course, we have the turnaround at mile 3. They're cruising down the road, seeing a lot of the neighborhoods here near Leon's Triathlon. They cruise through another water stop, make sure they get their hydration there. And then, of course, guys, they got the run for home. They're going to see Wolf Lake Park, they're going to hear the cheering fans, and they're going to be stoked because the finish line is just moments away.
When we come back, the women's side, Chris Wickard in control, but they are chasing her down. Can they catch her? Stay with us.
The 2012 IIHS top safety pick that comes with a Scion Service Boost complimentary maintenance plan just so happens to be the Scion XB.
Margaret Mattson Fine Jewelry, 312 South 3rd Street, Geneva.
Don't miss Gary's South Shore Air Show featuring the U.S. Air Force Thunderbirds July 6th through the 8th. Watch in amazement as military and civilian aircraft fly over Marquette Park in Gary. This annual show offers free admission, food vendors, and a beer garden. Free parking and shuttle available at the Majestic Star Casino and Hotel. Premium parking offered steps from the beach. A twilight show with fireworks provided by Crazy Kaplan's will be held on Friday, July 6th. Visit www.garyairshow.com for details.
What is Pods? A smarter way to move and store. We deliver a container, you or your packers fill it up with all the things that need a home while you move yours. Take all the time you need, then call us. We'll pick up your container and drive it to your new home across town or across the country, even to one of our many secure storage centers. That's Pods, the best moving and storage idea ever. Call today or visit pods.com for your free quote.
With a 5-star overall safety rating and Scion Service Boost complimentary maintenance plan, the Scion TC is made to handle the streets.
Welcome back to Leon's. As this race grows in popularity, some big news announced here this week by Trudy Marshall from the Best of US Tri Series.
We're absolutely delighted to announce that the 2013 Leon's Triathlon will be the host event of the Best of the US Amateur Triathlete Championship race. We are so excited about having it here at Leon's. You know, there's lots of different kinds of championship courses, but this is industrial strength, all out, pedal to the metal racing. And when you get the kind of talent from every state in the country that Best of the US gets, you'll be amazed at what's gonna happen and you will absolutely get chills.
This is where the fun starts.
How are we feeling?
Much better than before.
What were you feeling?
Just stomach wasn't right. Knee was hurting a little bit, but warmed up a little bit now.
You realize you're on a blistering pace right now.
Am I? I felt slow.
Such an interesting perspective, being able to talk to a guy during a race like that. as he passes by his coach, Adam Zuko, going the other direction, heading north. He's very comfortable, isn't he?
Absolutely. Another teammate, Jared Milam, bearing down on Zuko, going to pass Ben Knute here. To have the presence of mind when your heart rate's at 190, to be able to answer questions coming from the motorcycle, this kid's impressive.
He really is, and he knows the importance of nutrition. Time for Eat Healthy, Race Hard, brought to you by Strack and Van Til.
Hey, what's up, guys? I'm the Centered Chef, Ryan Hootmacher, and today we're working on the perfect fueling option for triathletes. It's a nutritional powerhouse. What we're doing is a quinoa tabbouleh with fresh fruit. So let's get started. Now, to start out the recipe, we have some quinoa that we cooked with some apple juice. We did 1.5 parts of apple juice to about 1 part of quinoa, and we simmered that for 12 minutes. We're gonna add a little bit of fresh mint. The fresh mint is gonna make it pop and be vibrant in flavor. Now we jump into our fruit right here. So we have some mangoes, which are gonna go right inside. We've got some grapes. We're gonna go with some red and some green grapes. We're gonna go with some strawberries for another sweetness, a little bit of acidity. Then, for antioxidants, we're gonna go help reduce inflammation over the long haul. We're gonna go with some blueberries right inside of there. Take a little bit of lemon, squeeze some lemon inside of here. To add a nice tartness, I'm gonna add a little bit of olive oil. So we're doing a healthy fat. Then we're gonna mix this together. All right, so this is the final recipe right here. This is the quinoa tabbouleh with fresh fruit. It's beautiful, it's clean, simple, sexy, and vibrant, and it's gonna stick to your ribs, baby. And that's the good stuff.
Yes, that is the good stuff. And here is some good stuff. Look at Adrian Shields bearing down on our two-time defending champion, Chris Wickard.
You can look at their running styles completely different. A three-peat is not in the cards for Chris Wickard. Her arms are crossing her chest. Adrian Shields looks light on her feet. She's actually sprinting by her, putting a tremendous gap in a very short period of time.
Adrian Shields, very impressive. We knew she was going to be strong in the run. We didn't know how strong, but she is headed towards the finish line, putting the two-time defending champion in her rearview mirror.
Tim, she has been working so hard on her run, and it absolutely shows here. She's flying down the race course. No one's going to catch her at this point. She had an interesting life change this year. She was a pilot. Now she's throwing her hat in the ring.
I had an opportunity as an airline pilot to take a long-term leave of absence, which was kind of a hard decision to make. But, you know, knowing that I've had some success and it's hard to train on the road, so to have the opportunity to step away from the job for a little bit and just focus on, you know, working out hard, recovering hard, and knowing that I can come back to the job when I'm ready, it was, you know, a great opportunity that I couldn't pass up. So I'm just, you know, trying to make the best of these years ahead and just see what I can do.
Coming up next, the finish, the men, the women. Who will get there first? Stay with us.
Leon's Triathlon is brought to you by Core Power, Fire Shark, the Indiana, Ohio, Kentucky Carpenters Union, Team N Training, Safeway Scaffolding, Passy Construction, Budweiser Fallen Heroes, and the Hammond Port Authority.
Tomorrow, catch a Northside showdown as two devout Cubs fans square off in the Batter's Box, presented by Midas. Tune in for the ultimate test of Cubs knowledge, hosted by Luke Stuckmeyer. Episode 1 premieres tomorrow at 5 on Comcast Sportsnet, fans' best friend.
After my grandmother, but I never got to meet her. And I've always been curious about the first Ellen. I started with Ancestry.com, just to see. All it took was her name. And there she was in a 1930 census, and there was her address. I lived 4 blocks away from there. I walked by that building every day.
Get started with your family history at Ancestry.com, and we'll help you make your own discoveries.
It's Pep Boys National Tire Event. Buy any tire at our guaranteed lowest prices. We will not be undersold. Buy 2 tires, get an oil change free. Buy 3, get the 4th tire free. Shop online 24/7 at PepBoys.com or hurry to Pep Boys now.
It has 11 airbags, including the world's first rear window airbag, and the highest combined MPG of any non-hybrid. It's the Scion IQ, and it's ready to outsmart the city.
Anticipation building at beautiful Wolf Lake Park as we await the triathletes. We want to thank the Sheriff's Department of Hammond for providing our aerial views today of this spectacular course. What a wonderful day, and what a wonderful day for Ben Canute as he heads towards the finish.
There is nobody behind him. I think he's got this one pretty much in the bag. To lead from the second he put his hand in the water to coming up to the home stretch here, it's got to be a great feeling winning from nose to tail.
So poised today, this kid. You know, you forget that he's only 19 years old.
And when he makes this turn for home and you see all the people, the excitement, you can see he's just putting his fist in the air. He knows he's got this one in the bag. He is so pumped. The butterflies are out of his stomach now. He flips his glasses up. He's gonna enjoy this last 100 meters.
Lots of folks to greet him. High fives. There he is, two times the champion, Ben Canute. An incredible time. 150.32. Congratulations to Ben Canute. He is the two-time champion. Go ahead and celebrate, Ben. Robbie down with him in the Scion winner's circle.
Ben, you've done it again, and you've not only won this race, you did it in record-setting fashion. How you feeling?
Oh, it's good to be done, but that was great. That was an awesome day. I mean, everything pretty much went right from the start. I had a great swim, great bike, and I was able to build into the run and finish real strong.
Ben, you made a comment during the run that you got a little bit sick, and then you said, looked at the camera and said, this is where the fun begins. Explain that.
Well, that first 5K was a little bit rough. I wasn't really feeling that great, but I just kind of built into it, and then once I hit the turnaround, I was feeling a lot better, so that's when the fun started, and I got to pick it up a little bit.
And there's Jared Milam with a strong second-place finish, getting a handshake from our champion. And there is Adam Zuko, the coach, coming in with a strong third-place finish. So there's your top five. Canute, Jared Milam, Adam Zuko, Dave Arian, 54 years old with the Endurant team, and Scott Ayotte. Training Bible, their team, strong today, four out of the top five.
Adam, what does this mean to have three guys finish 1, 2, 3, all with Training Bible?
Oh, it's awesome. I mean, it's just a great testament for what we've got going on, and not only that, but they're all great guys, too. So I love winning, but I love losing to my teammates, too. So.
Now to the women, and Adrian Shields finishing strong as she heads towards the chute and the finish line.
That's for sure. The complete opposite of the men's race where Canute led from nose to tail. She came out of the water way, way back, finished the bike pretty good, and just stormed her way into first place during this unbelievable run.
Her run is super, super strong. I know you coach her with the Vision Quest team. What is it about her that makes her such a strong runner?
Part of it, she's super light, and really the truth of the matter is she trains so hard and she's so dedicated. This is such a great payoff for all that hard work she's done over these last couple of years, and this is a great, great moment for her because the potential of her becoming a professional triathlete is coming to realization here today.
A commercial airline pilot taking a leave of absence and winning a race like this, what a moment. What's going through her mind right now?
She is on cloud nine. She is so pumped up running these final 150 meters. She will remember for the rest of her entire life as the moment she came on board as a professional triathlete. She is stoked. She is fired up. Crossing the line here in just a sec.
Adrian Shields, there she is. She wins the 2012 Leon's Triathlon. What a moment for her. Robbie talked to her in the Scion winner's circle.
Adrian, 2012 Leon's champion. What are your thoughts right now?
I really honestly didn't think that was going to happen. I was, you know, when I came off the bike, I think in fifth. And, you know, I was like, if I could get top three, that would be awesome. And, you know, I honestly don't know where that run came from.
I think you surprised a lot of people today.
Surprised myself. So.
Congratulations, Adrian. She finishes first, followed by Wickard, Zeffy, Wendorf, and Harrison. Jen Howland with a strong sixth place finish. Moving to the Zoot Team Challenge. The men's team, as we mentioned, four out of the top five with a Training Bible coaching team. The women's division, WellFit, won that one. And in the co-ed, Robbie's team, Vision Quest. Congratulations, Robbie. Now, as the age groupers start to stream in, obviously in an amateur race, so many people out here having a great time. Let's check in with the crowd. As the age groupers continue to stream past the finish line, so much team spirit on display out here. athletes supporting each other, families sharing the triathlon experience together. These are core values for Leon. That's what this event is all about.
I have done over 100 triathlons. This is my 25th year, and Leon's is the best. To have him shaking your hand, it just makes it all fun.
Leon did a great job with today, and you know, it's a beautiful day, carpe diem.
You know, it's great coming out and racing and being with all your friends, but also important is all the people that are out here supporting us, all the volunteers that are out there helping and, you know, giving out water and making sure that we're safe. So, but the end of the race and just finishing is a great accomplishment.
You know, you're trying, and this brings it all together.
You train hard, and then it's a pleasure when the training pays off. Even though I was dying, I knew that I'd had enough to make it, and that really feels good.
Leon, awesome!
It's awesome. We love to all come together and cheer for each other. There's nothing better than a strong team.
Can you feel it right now? It's great. Look at all the smiles, sunshine. The awesome race. Awesome race.
This race is awesome!
Well, another Leon's Triathlon in the books. And of course, the founder and namesake, Leon Woolock, joins us. And Leon, how do you keep pulling this thing off year after year? What a day.
It's a lot of humbleness and passion to create an experience. It's like the old Chicago Stadium. When you went there was something magical in that stadium. So our goal is to be that type of arena when it comes to triathlons.
Leon, this race was so competitive, so exciting. The energy here is just unbelievable. The crowd behind us. Where do you go from here? Where do you see Leon's in 1, 2, maybe 5 years?
The one thing I remember about Bill France Sr. when it came to NASCAR, he said, build it, they'll come. Our goal is to be the Daytona 500 of the triathlon community, and we won't rest until we get there.
Well, you are building it, and Leon, of course, as usual, you need a shave. Yes. You need a shower.
Yes.
And you need some sleep, my friend.
Absolutely. We've basically been going for 7 straight days, and we're averaging about maybe 1 to 2 hours per night. But what I've learned many, many years ago, how hungry are you? Our hunger is so intense right now, and our goal is to become everything we can be and drive it with passion.
Well, that is very apparent. You have achieved your goals today. So on behalf of all of us, Robbie and me and Leon and the whole crew here, we will see you next year at Leon's Triathlon.